Hello, welcome to Board Games with Niramas. I'm Joseph, I'm here with Draco, and today we're just going to do a short little video here about painting the 3D tiles in the Terraforming Mars big box, or if you just got the tiles separately. So what I'm doing here is I'm not really painting them. I'm using different kinds of washes, as it's called. It's really like thin color. I use the Citadel ones. It's the shade here, the Agarez Earthshade is my favorite one. I also did some, you know, tryouts here with the Seraphim Sepia, with the Nuln Oil, and the Agarez Earthshade Glossy. And then I also used some white over here as well. So we can start off there. I did some part here of the ocean tiles. And this was not using wash, this was using normal base paint, really. And what I did was I dry brushed these, as it's called. So what I'm looking for here, and as you can see, I just wanted a little bit of, let's see if I bring one close here. So I just wanted a little bit of basically wave foam, right? A little bit of white on the top. Now the way to do this, and I tried to do it in different masses as well. Some of these don't have much at all, almost nothing. And some of them have more. So I think when they go out on the board together, they're going to look nicely. So what I did there was just using a flat-sided brush like this, a little bit of white, basically dry off almost all the color, so it's like really dry, and then basically just go like this on top, and then a little bit of color will end up, but it's just going to end up on everything that sticks out, sort of, and not on the deeper parts, which actually makes sense, right, if we're looking for the wave effect. Let's talk about the actual tiles for the game. We have some special tiles. These I have used different kinds of washes on, maybe a little bit too much there, I don't know. Now I've tried to be very careful and remove, like, first I take a lot in the brush, I just get all over, and then I make the brush dry and just remove. And so what I really like here though is the fact that now the symbol here becomes very clear. So as you can see, the symbol very clear for the tile that's supposed to be placed here. As you can see, it also brings out the details on this little pipe line, the details on these little windows really nicely there. If we take a look at one of the tiles that I haven't done anything with yet, then you can see that it's, first of all, it's way, you know, it's harder to see the symbol there, it's way lighter. And also I really like, I mean, if we're on Mars, it's gonna be sand blowing and so on. You're not gonna have these perfect buildings with, you know, clean and perfect, right? You're gonna have a little bit of dirt there. Now let's take a look at some city tiles here. So again, the city tile here, it looks very clean and, you know, too clean in my opinion. So this is what I did here. This has dried, it's done. So as you can see here, all the little window sort of comes out. It looks a bit sandy and rough. It's been through some sandstorms on Mars. And again, symbol shows very nicely there. And every little detail pops, like every little cliff here. If we put it into one of these especially, then we remove some of the sort of dirt effect. But still, of course, if they had this on from the start, they would be protected from the sand, right? So I guess maybe my logic is off there, but I just like the look of this. Alright, then let's show you a little bit on how I do this. So I use brush, get a lot of this wash in here. I just start basically getting a lot of wash onto it. Because then I will remove as I go. I will basically cover it all like this. And now I will also say I'm not an expert in painting miniatures at all. I'm just a happy amateur. So if you have some good tips for me and for other people, then tell us in the comment section. Put your comment down there, your tips and trick for how to get a good look on your minis. And then I will read it and other people can read it and we can all learn from each other. There's a lot of tiles, of course, and I don't want to spend too much time on each tile. On the other hand, I will be playing with the copy lots of times, so I do want it to look nice. So I'll probably spend some more time on this, but let's also take a look at some greeneries. Now the greeneries come in different variations. We have the one with the little mountain here, and we have the one with more sort of forest in area in it. So let's get started. I haven't done these yet, and I'm not really sure how it's going to look on green. Again, I want this symbol right there to pop a little bit, the tree symbol there. I mean, we all know what a greenery is, right? And when we're supposed to place it, I just like that it's clear and showing. And these mountain ranges have small sort of nudges in them, which I do like to get a little bit of wash in there and in between the trees and whatnot as well. I'm hoping for a sort of more shaded look where everything is not as bright and colorful, because after all, it's trees, right? And again, sand on Mars shouldn't be too bright. So there we go. And now it hasn't dried, of course. It will change a little bit. It won't be as glossy when it dries. But I like the look of this. I like how the trees pop a little bit more and the cliffs in there. And yeah, this is a super easy way to just, you know, spice up your Terraforming Mars tiles a little bit. If you want to spend the time and do actual super close-up details, I'm sure you could do that as well. But this is just to get a little bit more structure to the tiles, a little bit more dirt in there, and yeah, more life to the tiles in a sense. Like the lava here, I think it looks way better with a bit more deepish color, a little bit more dirty, and like this is like a real cliff, and so on. So I hope this could be a little bit of inspiration to you. If you end up painting or washing or fixing your tiles, you know, please send me pictures. I would love to see some pictures over at bgwneromas@gmail.com. You can always send me an email with your images of how you painted them. It's always fun to see. And again, share your tips and tricks in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching this one. Have a great evening or morning, or whenever you're watching. Take care. Bye-bye.